July the 10th, 1980, the night when Ali Pali went up in flames for the second time in its 100-year history. The blaze lasted for 5 hours and the Great Hall was reduced to a shell. After the first fire in 1873, a new palace was opened just 2 years later. This time it's taken 7 years for the palace to come back to life. Some say it would have been easier to have knocked the whole place down. The insurance money from the second fire and a grant from the GLC were shrewdly invested by the charitable trust which runs the palace. Now they've got the full amount to pay for its renovation. Understandably, one of the top priorities is fire safety. £1.5 million has been spent on the roof alone. Silicone-coated fiberglass should ensure the ceiling is flame-proof.
The local people and Haringey Council, who are the trustees, were strongly in favour of restoring where possible. So what we did, wherever possible, we kept the walls and structures and reinstated those in their original design, and when we had to build the roofs we adopted new design to avoid the hall being blocked by columns.
The style of the second People's Palace, built in 1875, has been faithfully recreated, but there are additions, like the rose window designed by Maria McClafferty.
It's made of stained coloured glass, reflective glass and opalescent glass, and the idea is it will look different internally and externally by day and by night. So I think it will be something to be seen on the North London landscape.
The new palace opens in January for exhibitions, concerts, conferences and sports events. Tennis, athletics, a world title boxing fight and the British Gymnastics Championship are also due to be held here next year. They say the third Ali Pali will be more the People's Palace than ever before. Bob Hunt, Thames News.